Welcome to Java Forum. Now we are going to see how to install and configure Open Liberty 17 application server on Suse Linux Enterprise Server 12. So still many users are using Suse Linux Enterprise Server 12. For them this video will be useful. So here you can see that I already downloaded Open Liberty 17 zip file. So I'm going to extract this zip file to /opt directory. So Open Liberty is a IBM open source project, and it's a free and open source application server. It's free to use. So extraction is completed. So I am creating one directory and copying the extracted content to that directory. So this is the directory structure of Open Liberty 17 application server, which contains bin and lib directories. So Open Liberty 17 supports Java EE 7 modules. So we are going to point Oracle JDK 8. So here you can see that I already installed Oracle JDK 8. I'm going to point Oracle JDK 8 to run Open Liberty 17 application server. So open the terminal. So first I'm checking whether Java is available. Yes, it's available in the path. So now I'm going to Open Liberty WP bin directory. So I am going to execute the below command. So before that, I am giving permission to the Open Liberty 17 directory so that other users also can execute it. So now I am going to execute the below command. So I have created the server instance called Liberty Linux. So this will create one server instance. So under Open Liberty 17 WP, you can see that USR directory is newly created. So under USR directory, servers. So here you can see that Liberty Linux directory is created, which contains three directories: apps, drop-ins, and work area. So each server instance will have these three directories. So now I am going to start this server instance called Liberty Linux. So /server start Liberty Linux. So this is the command used to start the instance name Liberty Linux. So you can see that Liberty Linux is started, and you can see that it is running with the separate process ID. Now I am gripping the process with that process ID. Yes, I can able to see some processes running. Anyway, it is a good practice to check the logs. You can see that logs is generated under Liberty Linux directory. You can see there are two log files. So first we are checking messages.log. So in that all full details will be printed. So Liberty Linux instance is started in the port 9080. So 9080 is a default port of the first instance which I have created. So also you can verify console.log. Okay, now let me open the browser to check whether I can able to access the Open Liberty 17 homepage. as I told earlier, OpenLiberty 17 is supporting Java EE7 modules. Yes, it is successful. I can able to access the OpenLiberty application server homepage, which means we have installed correctly. So now I am going to stop the server /server/stop/liberty-linux. So this will stop the instance called Liberty Linux. Yes. You can also verify either gripping the process or by refreshing the browser. Now this is the command. I will list down the what are all the instances available under USR directory. /server/list. So OpenLiberty 17 application server installation on Suse Linux Enterprise Server 12 is successful.